Sometimes it gets so hard to write these words because life in America, it seems so absurd. It seems useless to have anything to say because we should be dealing with this thing another way. A way that would make us appear to be more as men and women instead of boys and girls, needing our parents' permission in a rapidly changing world. A world where each race will have to have its own fig tree and vine. It's now the unfolding of that time. But America has a fierce grip on our minds. Sometimes it seems like our very souls. Black on black crime, an unwillingness it seems like to unite. At any moment, we might have to fight a system that's a fracas, a shyster, and a sham. And about African people, it's proven it doesn't give a damn. They'd like to see us all dead, and why is it so hard for us to get this through our heads? Genocide against us every day, in every conceivable way, especially the African man. And have we forgotten the King Alfred plan? Now they're talking about reinstating new laws in order to maybe legally lynch our people. Well, even if we shouted from the highest steeple that we're tired of what happens to our people, the murder, the killings, the brutality, the rape, we're all standing here at Hell's Gate. It could move toward picking up that gun, and it wouldn't be for any fun. We'd get down to some serious business. Say we gather at least 100,000 strong. Let these folks know that they're wrong, that Brother Bamir isn't going to the electric chair, and we'd be willing to stand up to any of their dare. We won't despair, we'll just do what has to be done. We'll show that might, that force, that spirit when we come together as one. Brother Bamir, baby, don't worry about a thing, because they're not in control here, and there's really no reason for us to show any fear. Brother Bamir himself said these words to us, that there's nothing that they can really do to when your deepest principle you do hold true. And let them confront us with the threat of death. That's the most that they can do at its best. But when your perspective you do see clear, that threat of death, it holds no fear. Brother Bamir said that that's the bottom line. In the passing of time, the strong ones, they persevere and they stay. The weak ones, they slip and they fade away to the shade in order to escape the possibility of the grave, the heat of things. But we come to know who's who and what's what and who our true brothers and sisters are. Long live George Jackson. Long live Jonathan Jackson. Long live Malcolm X. And long live Brother Bamir. And if by any chance Brother Bamir should die, there should not be a single tear in our eye, only blood.